Kelly heads up the most powerful crime family in London, Clan Kelly, which should at least be easy to remember.
Under her old man, they were a bit player. Then he died, and her rivals started disappearing. Her enemies, her friends, her family. They call her Bloody Mary for a reason.
Early on, Mary abandoned cash in favor of cryptocurrency and brought the Kellys' criminal business online.
It makes weapon smuggling, drug running, money laundering all a lot easier without a cash trail. The woman single-handedly modernized organized crime in London. She considers herself to be untouchable. Case in point, from my files you retrieved. Darla Covington, 19. Sasha Haddad, 28. Radek Stankovic, 24. All disappeared.
It's difficult to find good help these days, isn't it, love? Most people, they ain't driven. Not like you. Because they feel worthless, don't they? The way that the world is, how it uses people. It's horrible. It's nice that you have a purpose. Oh, that'll be me, love.
We aren't finished here.
This was a courtesy. Oh. Give my regards to their families. It's horrible losing someone you love. Nice meeting you, Caitlin.
As you can see, she'll never respond to interrogation. But there is one place she feels comfortable talking, the Sandstone residence.
Inspector Lau thinks a police bug in the Kellys' headquarters may have the evidence she needs to finally convict Bloody Mary.
Sandstone is their center of operations. I know the data on that bug will take her down. Get it for me, and I swear I'll put her away forever.
Pushing the coordinates to your optics.
Sabine here, Inspector Lau. I'm curious how you think... Now, with no backing. Even before Albion took over policing, you couldn't lock her up. And she goes on treating humans like cattle.
I had to work within the system. Yes, it was corrupt. I knew it. I just didn't know how bad it was. I thought a strong enough case couldn't be buried.
We were all naive once. But what's your excuse now? The police answer to Albion. There's no more doing this by the book.
Because I'm taking it to a contact in the Attorney General's office, an honest solicitor with a hard-on for organized crime, specifically for Mary Kelly. Look, our methods may differ, but I want to help those people as much as you do.
All right, but however this goes down, there's no way we're letting Mary slip the net again. That's not how DedSec does things. Let's get to Sandstone.
Try to test me. They'll see what
I'm gonna fuck me, huh? We'll see.
out and look.
Security here is state-of-the-art, quite impenetrable. Unless, of course, you flew a drone through the window one of Mary's mouth breathers left open. DedSec needs your help.
Fuck yes!
Security here is state of the art, quite impenetrable. Unless, of course... Well, you flew a drone through the window, one of Mary's mouth breathers left open.
Set can access anything.
The recording device is in her security room.
Getting there should be a simple matter of navigating the vents.
What the fuck? She's using these people as house servants, against their will.
Horrible in itself, but a million times worse knowing they end up as unwilling organ donors.
You have a real fucking attitude problem, do you know that?
Please, I need help.
Fucking idiot. Do you piss everyone off the way you're pissing me off, you wanker? Stupid git.
That's it. Let's see what kind of recording we've got on her. Just look at this place. This is what comes of old crooked money. The Kelly family has been profiting from people's misery for a long time. She's got this shit all over the manor.
So you've been in there before? Is that how you ended up in the basement of the Southwark incinerator?
We needed something incriminating, so we decided someone had to get in here and plant a bug. I wasn't going to assign someone else to do that. You saw how Mary uses the people she grabs out of the EPC, and the staff's uniform's not hard to mimic, so I went in. What I didn't know was that she had intel on our investigation, my team. I thought going off book would stop the leaks, but she still knew we were coming. She tortured me for the names of my team. Tried to break me, but cops don't give up cops. Turned out she already knew the whole unit and put hits out on them. The woman is a mindfucker.
Shit. At least she didn't get microchipped. I think I'd rather die than have one of those in me fucking brain.
That's how I ended up on that butcher's table. So many reasons to want to rid the world of her, but it wouldn't be enough to just put one in her brain. My mates died trying to bring her to justice. I have to honor that.
Potter! Yeah!
Yourself after everything I've done for you.
You made me a slave. All of us. Please, let me go. Take this thing out.
Back to your old life.
Back to nothing. Back to your 2.5 screaming blighters in your dead end job and sucking off the dough.
You don't want that, love. This microchip is scary, I know, but I've got to keep tracks on my merchandise, don't I? And this kitchen knife, that won't do it, love. Cutting yourself affects my bottom line.
Newmark, I can't live like this anymore.
No. You're all right there. But it's all right, sweetheart, because I have another use for you. Ooh, paying attention, are we? Good, be sure and spread the word. You know where this one goes. Get these two and all the others over to the venue and ready for the sale.
Right away, ma'am. Also, the foreign investors have already landed and the drones are programmed. Ready to deliver the invitations and the coordinates to all the guests.
It's that initiative I'm smelling, Peter. Initiative can be a dangerous thing. Can be misinterpreted.
This is insane. How did Mary get her hands on this kind of tech? It takes a sick mind to come up with killer microchips.
Perhaps a diseased mind, but definitely an ingenious one. Perfect psych profile for a group like Zero Day, wouldn't you say?
Her affiliations aren't my priority, Bagley. She's keeping these people enslaved. And it sounds as if she's selling them. This is huge.
So that's what the microchip is for. If they disobey, she sells them for their fucking innards, like a used bloody car.
DedSec, we'll have to crash that slave auction. Get all the information we can out of there. The location will be on the invitations. She hasn't sent out the invitation yet, but when she does...
Bagley, monitor the drone networks. Give us a heads up when Mary sends out her fleet. Until then, I reckon we're in a holding pattern.
I'll get in touch if I hear about anything else that might interest you. Cheers, DedSec.
Every year, the same old...
Since we're waiting for our cordial invitation to Mary Kelly's tasteless theme party, we can finally get back to what really matters, solving the mystery of Zero Day. Who are they, and why did they frame DedSec for the
what
bombings?
What do we have, Bags?
Glad you asked. Today, the great AI detective has two leads for his dog's body politic. Obviously, Albion needs looking into, but I also have a more unusual thread for you to pull on. There's a new hacktivist group on the dark web scene called the 404. But instead of being in it for the lulz, this lot seems to be in it for the brutal reshaping of society by any means necessary. Sound like anyone you know?
All right. I've got some options.
I've marked both on your optic. There's a potential recruit you may want to check out. Pushing your location.
I hate putting Mary Kelly on the back burner while she continues to destroy lives with those microchips, but for now, we've no choice.
Then perhaps it's time to have a closer look at the elephant in the room. Nigel Cass, billionaire warmonger and current CEO of our local horde of thugs, Albion BMC.
Cass certainly profited most from the bombings. We can inspire London to resist from now till forever, but it still won't break Albion's grip on the city. Not with Cass at the top.
Fuck me. You want to ask, Mr. Cass? Pretty please, sir. Could you take yourself and your thugs out of London? That's a ballsy move, going after the man. I'll give you that.
Bagley's come across a possible gap in Cass's armour. An ex-insider, ex-friend with an axe to grind. He'd be an asset if we can find and convince him to work with us. Come to the safe house. We'll talk it through.
Right, let's talk about Albion PMC, the only British organisation to successfully oppress more of the developing world than the British government. Led by Nigel Cass, a man the partisan media calls a charismatic visionary, and Amnesty International calls a war criminal. Albion was given the key to the city to re-establish order following the bombings.
Timing's a bit too convenient, if you know what I mean.
It is. So that's two reasons why we need to find an angle on Cass.
We've found one. His name? Hamish Bilagi. Born in London, Bilagi was a recipient of the Cass Foundation Technical Scholarship at 14, which included a mentorship with Cass himself. At 16, Bilagi designed Cass's first drone fleet. Fun fact, Cass delayed the launch by a week so it would land on Bilagi's birthday.
Cass sounds like Bilagi's second dad. Why would he help us?
They had a falling out after an incident in the Niger Delta 3 years ago. A buried human rights investigation accuses Cass of ordering a drone fleet to wipe out a village protesting the construction of a pipeline, but the drones malfunctioned before they could. Bilagi is named as the likely saboteur. He's been on the run ever since, but now tracking data shows he's reappeared in London.
Shit, he's looking for redemption, like with the protesters. This guy designed Cass's drone fleet. I think he's trying to disarm Albion.
He covers his tracks well, but that's a good guess. Unfortunately, according to this Albion intelligence report intercepted by our friend Caitlin Lau, Cass knows Bilagi's in London as well. So, that's the op. Make contact with Bilagi before Albion finds him, then convince him we have a mutual enemy in Cass.
So this guy's our best chance to stop Albion and clear our names. And the largest private army on Earth wants him dead. No pressure.
It took some doing, but I've narrowed down the area where we're most likely to find Hamish Bilagi. I've pushed the coordinates to your optic. Are you ready for a new operation?
Sure. Could use the workout.
Bellagio has been snooping into Albion's affairs. Quietly, of course, but I've been able to determine that most of his activity stems from this area.
All right. Let's go talk to the man.
Not so fast. Haymitch isn't in, according to his home security. And before you get ideas, he's rigged his front door to a series of traps designed to delete all of his data and then your life. Not necessarily in that order.
Paranoid fellow, huh?
To be fair, you are an armed insurgent trying to break into his flat. Anyway, you should be able to connect to the local grid and use security cameras to disarm his traps.
Got it.
I believe the main interface is on the rooftop.
Can we get in through those windows up top?
Sure, if you can get there. Three options here. One, use the window washing platform. Two, find a cargo drone. Three, give up, go home, and resolve to be a better person.
Fine, I'm on it. Shit. I feel like if I breathe too hard, I'd blow this place sky high.
You could force the traps to unlock by rewiring the power.
Fine, I'm on it.
Welcome to Clear and Present Danger, and welcome to Fascist London. Don't let that boot on the back of your neck disturb you. In time, you'll barely feel it. We have to wake up, people. If there was a playbook for setting up a totalitarian police state, Albion would be most of the way through it and working on the epilogue. They certainly took advantage of the fallout from the bombings, didn't they? Preyed on the fears of the city government, too. They were only too happy to hand Nigel Cass the keys to the city. Wash the hands to the whole mess. The collar will only get tighter now, friends, unless we do something. We can't wait for someone else to fight back. We are the change.
Traps are disarmed. Now, if you go through the front door of the flat, it's much less likely you'll be killed.
Move one more muscle, Chief, and I'll blow the whole place with you in it.
You don't want to do that, believe me.
Who the fuck are you? And what are you doing in my flat? You with Albion?
Think a little more underground.
What, Deadsec? Yeah, right, and I'm Che Guevara. You're done.
Listen. Albion knows you're in London. You have got to run. Go!
Fuck me. You're telling the truth, aren't you? Fucking hell, thought I was careful. Fucking idiot, Amish! Look, Cass is worse than you know.
Yeah, we know. Why do you think I'm here?
Maybe, because Nigel Cass is paying you. That's how fucking mercs work.
I'm no mercenary. We came here to get your help putting Cass down. He tried to pin the bombings on us.
Mate, you don't know shit. You have no idea what Cass is and what...
Move!
Fuck! An Albion squad's closing in on you. I guess
Damn
you weren't lying about that part. Fuck. Shit, fine. Move the table. I'll buy you some time. Just go.
Found
out!
Suspect is gone. Issue an APW.
I think all that excitement convinced our new friend Hamish that we need to work together to tackle Cass. He's willing to cooperate.
All right, Chief. That was a pretty slick escape. I believe you. So I'll say this. Nigel is planning something. And I don't think I could stop him on my own. If DedSec's everything I've heard, you'll help me.
We can help each other. There's a chance Cass had something to do with the bombings. What could he be planning that's worse than that?
No, that's not like him. Well, not... Exactly. See, Nigel's got to see himself as the hero. He's an arrogant twat, but he's not a cynic. Every place we go into, we... could have some mad plan to fix all his problems. With robot police or automated crop fertilizing or some shit. Society was a technical problem. And people are just bugs in the software, you know? You work around them or you squash them. Sorry, Chief. I've got to switch proxy servers so they don't trace me. I'll hit you right back on voice. Listen. I've got an inside man, right? A contact in Albion. Says Nigel's got this big meeting happening at White Tower. He'll be talking about a major project he's got planned for London.
What we need is an insider on the team.
I've always wanted to be in on a caper. Okay, first things first. We'll need eyes on the impregnable target, so off you go. I'll crack on with assembling the right personnel to round out this ragtag bunch of misfits.
Ah, shit. I'll be in cyber security sniffing my proxy IP. Must have traced the detonator signal. I've got to deal with this.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
This is 404, the first peer-to-peer hacktivist network. All are welcome. If you want to make a difference, join us. We're taking down the elite, one contract at a time.
Found that on the dark web. Looks like all the cool kids are forming hacker groups these days. But this 404 might actually come in handy in our fight. If all are welcome, that means we are too. I say we infiltrate 404, we get their connections, we get their assets.
If you play nice, they might even help you take out Zero Day. For that matter, maybe they are Zero Day. Only one way to find out. I found street view images of a CTOS hub that's been covered in 404 graffiti. They're marking their territory like an overexcited chihuahua. Dropping the location of the hub on your map.
Tell me you got a plan to get me into the Tower of London. And it's not pretend to be a...
I'd like to help, fam, but Knight just caught a whiff now. Before the CTOS cameras, it'd take him less than 5 to ID me. I ain't risking my pretty face.
We need an Albion insider for our caper, one who's willing to turn coat. I've reached out to a contact who works in a nearby pub. Where better to find a bleakly disillusioned anti-hero numbing their conscience with drink, but secretly desperate for redemption? I've let our contact know what we're in the market for, and she's nearby.
Hey.
You lot certainly know how to pick your targets. You do know that Albion have set up their headquarters in there, right?
It's what we signed up for. Kaz wants to unveil some secret project at this meeting, and we may be the only people standing in his way.
Fucking Nigel Kaz. You're right. Nothing good can come of this. Luckily, I hear loads of sob stories working in our pub. And near this place, quite a few from Albion are dissatisfied with the status quo. You turn on the charm, and I'm sure you can get one to join the good guys. Even got a candidate in mind.
Interesting. Send me their details.
I'll have Bagley push it along. Good luck, love.
We're aware of an Albion employee who might be approachable.
Oh, we're just supposed to find an Albion PMC and show them the light?
They're jackbooted thugs who regularly murder civilians. If finding a disenchanted employee is really that difficult, humanity's much worse off than I thought. It would also be quite useful to have someone on the inside.
For however long that lasts, Nigel's real good at sniffing out spies.
Personal experience speaking.
Yeah, not really in a sharing mood right now, fam.
Reporting to base. Incident under control.
Are you ready to do your part and take back the city?
Fuck me. Dead sec. All right, maybe you could help. Got myself in a bit of trouble.
We'll see. What's the problem?
My friend's got this rare blood disorder, and with the NHS in the state it's in, he hasn't been able to get proper treatment in months. A Clancelly doctor offered an experimental treatment. A pricey experimental treatment. We didn't have a lot of choices, so I paid.
Keep talking.
The meds were working. My mate was getting better, but then, well, he got hooked. That's when the doc suddenly decides to rack up the prices. That piece of shit knew what he was doing.
Sounds like a real piece of shit. Don't worry, we'll get your friend the medicine they need.
Well, this quote-unquote doctor is a real winner. He was struck off the medical register for gross malpractice last year, and now he's a freelance mob surgeon. Nice work if you can get it.
Bagley, think you can track him down?
I am quite literally always tracking everyone down. Pushing you his coordinates now. Kelly, doctor you're looking for is close.
He's got a laptop
with him too, presumably with a folder somewhere on it labeled crimes.
Well, don't just do that. We've got an intruder.
Kiss your tech goodbye.
Scraped. Get to safety while I analyze the data.
Here we go.
Thank you. I found them a warehouse where experimental drugs are being stored. I'm sure Mary Kelly won't mind if you nick a few. Vehicle with the drugs in it. Try not to destroy it.
Let's get to work.
Find this fucker.
There's jack shit going on here. You're going to go to wet messing with me.
Got the vehicle. Now what?
I found a safe location where our friend can pick it up. Sending you the coordinates now.
Thank you. Took care of it. We got the drugs to a safe location. Our AI will send you the coordinates. Hope this helps your friend.
I owe you guys big time.
Dead Sec's always looking for more people. You interested?
You kidding? Hell yeah!
We have an Albion operative on our roster. We should let them know they're needed.
Welcome to the team. Hope you're ready for this.
Bang in. Hype to expose the bastards in charge, yeah?
Nice.
Nigel Cass's meeting will begin soon. Approach the Tower of London when you're ready.
Get the fuck out of here!
I owe you.
Fuck is this, what?
I've lost sight of the target. Over.
Terminating the search. Control, put out an APW.
Every star I see is mine.
we're lucky, word hasn't spread that you've hung up your jackboots. Just try to put on your meek, harmless, broken-by-the-system face. Oh, and don't forget your uniform. Looking sharp. Your ex-colleagues won't pay any attention to you unless you let them take a close look. A word of caution now we're inside. Any disturbance in here and Nigel Cass will surely cancel his meeting. Avoid being detected by your former colleagues or this operation is a bust.
Nigel won't have anything important on this floor.
Seems no scads about him, more than most.
Yeah, I was Albion too, if you hadn't tweaked to that. Me and...
Intruder alert! Intruder alert!
Faster, more efficient.
Intruder alert! Intruder alert! Intruder alert! Intruder alert!
This new project the director's presenting these days is great.
See it roll out. This is going to make our jobs that much
easier
and safer.
Yeah. You don't think it's going to make certain aspects of our job redundant, do you?
Not a chance. The replica car takes care of its own. You know that.
Fair point.
Talk about empowering my abilities. That's wicked.
Intruder alert! Intruder alert!
Everything is proceeding on
track. They're down close, but they're coming in. Last time I've got enough to do. Beat them.
I heard someone saying dead sick.
They better not be just a bunch of terrorists pretending to have morals.
This door clearly requires a security pass.
Fucking great.
Use one of the nearby computers to create your forgery.
Be careful. You don't want to know what Nigel does with trespassers.
You've been up there, Leah? Yes, I'm part of your city.
Get the muck out of my work.
You understand?
Yeah, I know what you mean. But there's always the issue.
Sure, but that's what we're taking care of them.
You mean dead set? I've heard some talk on the street that they may be back in operation, but I'm not moving to stop them.
I'm not sure. There's some rumblings out there.
Sounds like they're moving back to something. Well, they are out there and still in the park.
It'll take some time for the forgery to be ready. To keep you occupied, I dragged up still images and a recording from an internal investigation into Cass Sr.'s death.
Show me.
Internal Psych Assessment AS001, Subject Cass Nigel. Mr. Cass experienced a deeply traumatic event when he witnessed the murder of his father, Gareth Cass, CEO of Albion. He began exhibiting symptoms soon after what he frequently described as the random event. Mr. Cass's initial symptoms included insomnia, paranoia, distorted blame, and recurring flashbacks. However, he appears to have channeled his anger and self-described powerlessness into his work to ensure that Albion become, quote, a mechanism for preventing unpredictable violence. It seems somewhat of a mania, edging on psychosis. For me, this raises concerns about Mr. Cass's fitness to run a multinational security company, but I cannot, at this time, make any recommendation beyond continued monitoring, especially considering that I have been asked to close this file.
Fuck me. Almost makes you pity him. Oh, wait. No, it doesn't. He's a dickhead. Can't believe that's who's supposed to be secure in London.
Yeah, well, Nigel's never close to anyone but his dad. And me, I guess. Never had much faith in people, really.
Well, the pass is ready, but rough. If this resistance thing doesn't work out, I doubt you'll make a living as a document forger. Let's give it a go anyway. Nigel Cass awaits.
Stop answering your calls. You can't get hold of it.
How's it going? Seems a bit tense.
Mr. Cass knows what he's doing. It'll do you no good to question his directive.
I'm not questioning his bloody directive. I'm wondering why we're not being sent out.
Burn down, that's what I told you. Yeah.
Maybe because
the whole damn building.
Welcome to Project Themis.
Our new autonomous drones. These drones can identify, isolate, and terminate threats before they can do harm. They can go anywhere, see everything. They could kill a man alone in an alley or in a crowd of hundreds with perfect precision. Themis drones can do what humans have always struggled to. Act immediately and decisively. Without your support, I couldn't stand here and tell you, no, promise you, that with the launch of Project Themis, London will be the first city in the world to be made truly safe.
Mr. Cass, I was hoping you'd called us all in here today to discuss the ethical issues.
No, it's all right. The Commissioner cares, as we all do. I admire his passion and his dedication. Let's talk ethics.
Well, for one, Themis goes far beyond Albion's mandate. We really should have more government consultation.
I see. Delay the launch so that we can debate and assess the details.
We're missing the human element here. I can get the Defense Minister on the line right now.
Well, if you feel you must. It's the human element that got us into this. No more debate, delay, indecision. Understand this. I will not allow anyone, not even myself, to jeopardize Themis. Now, will our friends at Tidus be ready? You are the cornerstone of the project after all. Do you need to consult any outside parties?
No. We'll be ready.
And just in time. Criminals running our streets. Illegals threatening our families. The police commissioner himself. Assassinated by terrorists. Decisiveness is hard. But here's the best part. Once this decision is made, no more will be required of you.
A building-wide security sweep has been initiated due to document breach.
I warned you about that, Fordry. Your uniform will help. Don't let them get a close look at you.
Bagley, need an exit protocol.
The catacombs, fam. Your action in there, didn't you? Man can be very persuasive.
Sounds like he plans to launch Themis ASAP. From the way he was talking, I don't think it's the sort of genie that goes back in the bottle. Shit.
Can't complain about more dosh.
I don't like this at all, man. What the fuck? Was that?
Fucking hell. Albion's top secret project is an automated killing machine. And it looks like Cass is almost ready to launch. We have to get Themis out of his hands.
I'll prepare a briefing. Will we see you there, Hamish?
Pretty face, not risking, remember? But patch me in. You and me got some scheming to do, Bagley.
Make it stop!
What?
Come here. ID check.
Not me, buddy. Wrong guy.
Over here. ID check.
No. You made a mistake. Not me.
No movement during the scan.
Nervous, are we?
I hope nothing's wrong.
No movement during the scan.
Fuck you.
You're clear. Move along.
What's up with him, Bagley?
Looks like he's a marked man. Clan Kelly put a bounty on his head.
Why?
He's an uncommonly dangerous underground boxer. Apparently he once won a fight with a bag of cement, however you do that. And in his last match he took down a mob-backed favourite. Now they're sending out an enforcer to make sure he never wins again.
Well, that's hardly a fair fight, is it? Bags, give me a trace on that enforcer.
Already done. I'll start the briefing whenever you're ready. Here's what we know about Nigel Cass. He's rolling out something called Project Themis. The lack of information on its own is worrisome. But what little we do know is Cass wishes to remove the human element from law enforcement.
We also know he's partnered with Titus, which is never good. Titus does other work with Albion. Nasty shit like autonomous weapons, human targeting algorithms.
So Titus is our best lead to fill in the blanks on the secret project, but their security is notoriously difficult to crack. So Hamish has proposed an intriguing solution.
Albion's been working on a new microdrone, something my contact told me about. That shit's not even in production yet, but if we get the plans, we can manufacture our own.
To bypass Titus security?
Exactly, exactly. They're weird as fuck. Supposed to do maintenance on Albion's other drones, but the smallness of them means they can slip into places nothing else can.
Well, there we have it. Our next step is to infiltrate the Albion drone manufacturing lab and get our hands on schematics.
And then you lot will have a fun little gadget to break into Titus. Love it. I'll shoot you the location. Be careful. Albion doesn't like to share his toys.
I just can't handle this right now.
Did you see something?
Nice with me.
Well,
I'm not looking for trouble.
Huh? Rob a barrel and end up in a chase
Set calling. You're up.
Nice. Technology's one step closer to replacing us.
Making it right.
coming up on the Albion. Drone facility where the micro drone is being developed.
This better be worth it.
It will be. You're gonna need to disable the security system protecting the R&D lab.
Security's down in the R&D lab, but plans for the microdrone will be in there somewhere. Downloaded the schematics. You can leave whenever you like. Now that we have the schematics, we can make micro drones of our very own.
Better move fast on that, Bags. We need to get into Tidus ASAP. Shut down Project Themis before Nigel decides to launch. And with what he was saying, we don't have much time.
Potential recruit for you. Drop in a pin on your map. We've successfully trialed our first micro-drone, and it's officially as cute as the Dickens. I've decided to name it Sebastian.
Time to break into Titus.
And take away Nigel Cass's newest toy, Project Themis. Bagley, any idea where that name comes from?
Greek mythology. Themis was the goddess of divine justice. You know, the one with the sword.
Ooh, that is so Nigel fucking Cass.
See? School's useful for something besides social maladjustment. Find the schematics of the building and I'll work out the location of the Themis project.
Look round for anything named Themis.
Fine, I'm on it.
Something's wrong with that bot.
Well, if I was hiding a top-secret morally dubious drone project like Themis, I would put it in the secure vault on the lowest level. You will have to hack your way past... Serious security, however. The elevator that leads to the secure vault that houses Themis is locked down. You will have to access the bypass terminal to use it. You will require a spider bot.
Let's have a look around.
Damn, this isn't good.
Let's make things interesting.
You'll be using Sebastian and the rest of the microdrones to bypass security. But first you'll have to get by that laser array. I suggest a spider bot and steady nerves.
Fine, I'm on it.
Our job is not an easy one, but it is an important one. Right now we devote countless hours to intelligence gathering and still things slip through the cracks. We're doing our best, you tell me. We are, but our best isn't good enough. That doesn't sound right. But even we aren't perfect yet. Yeah, they'll like that. That strikes a humble note. We make errors in judgment. That's human nature. But we cannot afford errors. We are the last resort to protect the people. Project Themis will dispense justice and protection. It will use data to predict the patterns of crime and abuse. It will let us transcend the faults in our own nature. Not bad. Yeah, they'll have questions, of course, which is fair. It's an extreme measure. And there is potential for abuse, but this is what London needs.
Sebastian, this is what you and your friends have been training for. Time to crash the security grid for Daddy.
Big things come in small packages, right?
That's the spirit. She'll be pretty sick.
Yeah.
Sebastian, no!
Right then, no time for tears. Meet Sebastian, another of our countless microdrone allies. All named Sebastian, of course. You can't iterate on perfection. Destroy them, Sebastian, and for God's sake, be careful. You've made your father very proud, Sebastian. Oh. You should be able to access the Themis project room now.
Let's ruin Nigel's fucking day!
Thank you.
London, once a beacon of civility, now a cesspool of lawlessness. It is clear that humanity can no longer police itself. Fortunately, we don't have to.
Welcome to Project Themis. Albion has found a way to apply an existing system, LifeScore, a data aggregator of biometrics, personal information, to our new autonomous drones. These drones can identify, isolate, and terminate threats before they can do harm. They can go anywhere, see everything. They could kill a man alone in an alley or in a crowd of hundreds with perfect precision. Themis drones can do what humans have always struggled to. Act immediately and decisively.
Fuck me, I knew it! The LifeScore algorithm, my algorithm. I should have scrubbed it before I left.
What do you mean, Hamish? You know how Themis works.
No, fam. Well, yeah. This was years ago. We were developing a LifeScore algorithm for what Cass called a peacekeeping system. Supposed to identify vulnerable civilians, not target them.
Shit.
So in theory, Themis could be programmed to target anyone based on any number of parameters.
Exactly. That's the way Cass thinks. Genius, but twisted. We have to stop this. And I know how. We delete the LifeScore data, and Themis is done.
Fuck. Fine. It's done.
Yes, we'll have the award ceremony another time. Get out now. This may be entertaining. I've intercepted an audio transmission from Nigel Cass.
Now this is more my style.
No more excuses. This is my city, and I will not have DedSec ruin my plans for it. Themis was poised to change London, the world. And this group of... And Hamish fucking Balaji? I want them all. They made you all look like fools. They walked calmly into the White Tower, and no one, not one of you, stopped them with all our vaunted security measures. So do any of you have anything to say? Nothing. Well, everyone, and I mean everyone, in the organization will be re-vetted immediately. Someone help them, that's certain, and we will root them out. This time, we will get them all.
Well? That's about done it. Cass is gonna steam about this for a while. No more LifeScore, no more Themis. You did it.
You helped us shut it down. You're a solid player, Hamish. We could use you down the line. Cass is still at large.
Not much of a joiner, fam. Considering how my days at Albion ended. I'll be keeping watch on them and Cass. Maybe feed you lots of intel.
And there's still the question of Zero Day. Remember them? Completely gutted DedSec 1.0.
Cass had a hand in that purge, Bagley, and in the bombings. So we'll gladly accept any help you can give us, Hamish. Cheers.
That's the CTOS up there.
If you are listening to this, it means you want to learn more about 404. Know what we know. Do what we do. Make your way to the walkie-talkie club. It's no big secret that the club is a front for Clan Kelly, but the place has other secrets too. More will be revealed there.
The hub just dumped a massive load of data into your optic. How forward.